Yo, what's going on, guys? Gonna be showing you how to carry on Renekton top lane here in season 12 League of Legends. For your best runes, you're gonna want to take Prestige Attack, Triumph with Alacrity, Last Stand, Bone Plating with Unflinching, with double adaptive and armor or magic resist depending on the matchup. Up against Volibear, it's gonna be doing mostly physical damage. Abilities do some magic damage as well. What we're gonna do is start getting our Fury going. We'll get a couple autos down and make last hitting a little bit easier. And right when he steps up, we're gonna start poking him down with our Q. And we don't really want to miss any CS. It's really important to keep our CS high. We'll hit him with an auto attack Q. He no longer has his ability. And we have a bunch of Fury built, so our next Q is gonna do even more damage, and it's going to heal us as well. Step four, try to nick him with it, but he backed off. He's gonna crank through his mana pretty quickly. Since we have Doran Shield, he's not gonna be able to do much to us. We'll go ahead and just try to dump the wave. Gonna get our E next so we can start forcing some damage on him. We'll dump wave off this cannon wave. It'll make it a little bit easier. I wanna hit him with all three autos here. Then we'll hit him with a Q. Auto attack E back out. Your Q's on a long enough cooldown, you can only use it once per burst cycle, to where a lot of the times it's best to proc your press the attack so you can maximize your damage output. Gonna walk up, auto attack W reset, E through him, hit him with our ignite, Q, auto attack E, down he goes. His wave's pushing to us right now, we should just back. When we come back, it'll be in the perfect spot. You can take teleport on Renekton. I wouldn't recommend that unless you're in a matchup where you don't think you can get an early kill. If you are in that type of matchup though, you should consider dodging because Renekton's late game is extremely inconsistent. He only has one CC tool and it's single target and it's auto attack based. So if you get blinded, you can't even use it. It's not a very consistent CC tool because it's also melee. Wave's in a perfect spot, we won't be gankable, and we'll get an XP advantage. Aw, barely missed that one. We do need to thin out these melees. He's trying to dump the wave since he just used that ability. He's gonna need his jungler to help him break this freeze. We have item advantage, it's gonna be hard for him to break it on his own. Whenever your Fury is up to the red mark, your Q and your W will be doing bonus damage, so will your E. You usually lean more towards your W though, because it makes it much easier to proc your press the attack, because your W applies three on-hit effects, which is nice. So you can auto-attack W reset and do some absurd damage. Or you could just raw and power W to get it if you really want to. Usually you want to auto-attack W though, to be a little bit more efficient with damage output. That was a weird spot. That must have been an accident, seeing that. We're starting to take a little bit too much damage. Didn't want to miss cannon, so I used my W. Things were getting dicey. Well, Ian hit him with the Q. He still has way more minions, so even if we AoE the wave a bit, it's not the end of the world. It's nice to hit them with your Q and the minions to maximize your self-healing. He's just playing so far back, it's making it very difficult to do so. Next time he throws out his thing, I'll take a big trade on him. I'm a little nervous because I don't know where Vi is, though. Once his shield ends, we'll look for a big trade. So far back. Auto-attack W reset. Auto-attack E. Got him with our Q. Kite this back. He is sitting on it. I'm waiting for his thing to time out on us. Yeah, he just died. Auto attack W reset. If you're wondering what I was waiting for, is he, that little claw mark you see on me, if that's on us and he goes to use it again, it does, I believe, even more damage, and I know that it gives him a crap load of healing. His ignite's on a cooldown, and we still have our ignite plus R. We're in a great spot here. I'm going to go ahead and reset since we dumped the wave. I don't want to stay. I'll put myself at risk of getting ganked by the Vi. It's all about playing around your cooldowns and fighting when yours are up and taking good trades when theirs are down. So when he used his E from a distance there, he lost out on his shield and a lot of his burst. That's his E. So right when he went to put that on cooldown, and then once his shield ended, we knew we could take an all-in fight. And even if you don't think you can win an all-in fight, feel free to E in, auto-attack W reset into Q. You'll be applying your press C attack and hitting them with all of your abilities. Then you'll auto-attack E back out. You're pretty much going to be mixing in an auto-attack in between every single ability for the most part. If you're not weaving in autos in between your abilities, you're missing out on half your damage. Since that's his long-range farm tool, he's also pushing the wave with it on accident. He needs a Vi-Gank, but it's starting to get to the point where I have such a lead on him. I don't think the Vi-Gank would really do anything at this point. I could probably kill both of them on our R. Renekton's also very dangerous the lower he is on HP. If you're below half HP, you build your Fury 50% faster. So instead of getting 5 Fury per auto attack, you get, I guess, 7.5. Missed a minion, oh well. Still holding the freeze. He's playing it so safe. If he goes in at all, we know that Vi's here. As long as he's not level 6, I should be able to kill both. As I see, she has 3 freaking kills. I'm gonna get a ward down in the bush just in case Vi tries to lane gank. If you have a beautiful free setup, most likely you'll get ganked through the lane. It's the easiest spot for them to do it, to get closest to you. You can stand on top of the minions and just press S to farm easier. The closer you are to the minions, the easier they are to last hit. Rather than you having to try to time from a distance walking in, you can just stand there and just pop them. Same thing with range champions. If you're a range champ, standing on top of the minions makes it way easier to farm because your auto gets there faster. You're mainly competing with the ranged minions. They do way more damage than the melees. You have to really be paying attention to where they're attacking. So right now, all Void Bear can do is try to get XP, maybe get a minion here or there. He could look for a roam, but the second he looks for a roam, I could threaten his turret plates and build an even bigger lead. We auto attack W reset there because we're going to miss the minion otherwise. We could have used our Q. That would be a decent option. It has a lot of AoE though, so we'd really have to stand off to the side to nip it. I was on a time crunch there. Your E is also AoE, and you don't want to be using that to farm minions because your E is a very, very long cooldown. Oh my god, just missed Ganon. Happens. We're going to max E second for the cooldown. Very important. He shouldn't have flashed. He should have just used his R to get away. His R is a very low cooldown in comparison. That was a massive panic move on his part. My wave's pushing out anyway, so I'm going to dump it here and look for a reset. This guy isn't really willing to trade with us, so we can't stay here forever unless we hold a freeze. So the second you can tell your freeze isn't going to hold, oftentimes it's best to just dump it. I think Vi's coming. Oh, wow. For a second I thought he backed. We can hit him with an auto-attack WQ as he steps towards the back line here. Or just a WQ. We did more damage to him than we took, and we can heal it off with our Q. We're not burning any mana. I have a control ward. I'm going to E in real quick. Auto-attack W reset. We'll hit him with an ignite. And do you remember how I said that... Your Q is only up enough in these fights to really use it once. That's why we didn't Q initially there. Because your Q has more range than your autos. So in that fight where we went in with our E auto attack W reset, we didn't want to Q early because he was still within our auto attack range, which would have made queuing early just like wasteful. It's on a 7-second cooldown. Now, if your Q is on a 2-second cooldown, then sure, you can use it earlier to use it again. But it's just on such a long cooldown. Our fights aren't going to last more than 7 seconds, whether it's a quick trade or whatever. We see Vi's bot side. We'll step up. Auto-attack W reset. Auto-attack E to the side. We didn't take a turret shot, but we still nipped him with that E damage. We see Vi's mid right now. She doesn't want to help this guy so far behind. I don't really blame her. It's really hard to help your laners when they're this far behind. He doesn't have flash, but his R might be up. We can walk up WQ him. Yeah, we baited out his Q. We solo applied our press the attack with that because your empowered W applies on hit effects three times. So whether that's Bork or Wit's End or whatever, any kind of on hit effect three times, including the press the attack, counts as three autos. It does not give you bonus fury though by doing that. So don't think you're getting free fury by using your W. That's not how that works. That would be so busted. About 100 differential. Yeah, the differential is the same. The only time you would ever want to do an empowered Q over an empowered W is if you're looking more for the healing to stay alive and you're hitting multiple champions with your Q since your Q's AoE. But in a single target fight, your W is way better to use than your Q empowerment. Because the damage differential is the same. It's about 100. Except your W applies to press the attack instantly. And the stun lasts twice as long. So if you don't need the extra HP and you're hitting multiple targets, you're always going to lean towards empowered W versus empowered Q. Power Q is mainly just for extra HP. I'll attack E through again. Oh, I could kill him with a flash Q. Don't want to burn my shunt down. He's dead. Just the W alone there killed him, which is insane. Level 1 W, 316 damage, plus the press the attack application, which is doing about 114 damage. Vi's looking for the top gank. She is a full item. That's a little bit scary. Definitely can't fight her right now. We'll look for the reset. We have our Gore Drinker. Usually mix this in and then Q. We'll go for Plated Steel Cap into Hysterix. Death's Dance is a great item on Renekton. The ability haste it gives is ridiculously valuable since we are a zero mana cost champion. And Black Cleaver is really useful for the same reason. They have triple physical damage and the jungler top are physical to where Death's Dance is very appealing. I kind of want to go Black Cleaver second item here since I am so fed. I would love to have lower cooldowns. We could freeze this wave. This is huge. The turret plates are about to fall off anyways, and we've gotten three of them. There's not much incentive for us to push this. Hey, buddy. We're pushing him away from the wave. I'm sure he's loving that. I only wanted to nip one minion there. I wasn't trying to hit two. Think of your Gore Drinker as just an extra auto attack. It does have an animation to it, so keep that in mind. It's not... like, you can't just use it and move at the same time. You have to stand still for half a second like you see there. Can't quite reach him. I'm gonna let it go. He is burning his mana, so kind of is what it is. He still has a ranged caster creep advantage, so his wave will push to me, plus he's using his AoE. Wise thinking about coming topside. He has a Bramble Vest, so we're not gonna wanna auto or W him, or we're gonna wreck our own self-healing. If Vi shows up, we'll just try to focus Vi instead, because I don't want to get heal cutted. Bramble only heal cuts you if you're hitting them with autos or auto based abilities. I know she's in the area, but I saw her on her blue. He just put his Q on cooldown. That was foolish. He must be maxing his E first just to farm. Three minions should still be more than enough to hold this. Got him with the Q Gore Drinker. Should have Gore Drinker then Q though. I think that would have been cleaner. Yeah, this wave's gonna end up getting pushed now. All attack. Oh, Gore Drinker. Holy crap, and they got me. That's exactly what I was worried about. The Vi is pretty big herself. She's a full item to match my full item. Nearly killed the Renekton, still had my flash. If I would have used it sooner, we might have lived. We took mostly physical, a little bit of magic, and a little bit of true damage. True damage was from the ignite. More armor here would be pretty solid. Since we talked about Renekton, he's stronger basically if he's half health or lower because he gets his fury faster. That's why Death's Dance is so good on him. I'm actually going to go ahead and start buying into Death's Dance. I think it's worth it. We should be able to stay top lane and split. I think team fighting would be very, 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 very bad for us because Ezreal Giga outranges us. So does the Lux and their support champion as well. So in a split push environment, we should still be able to handle Volibear for the longest time. And yeah, I think team fighting this game would be bad overall. I'm gonna force him to hit me instead of the minions. I don't have Bramble or anything. I'll attack WQ. Missed him with my Gore Drinker. That kind of sucks. I'm also really low on health now. That wasn't really worth it. Yeah, this is bad. I was thinking about Flash in there, but I saw her Q really early. Nice try from the Lux. Very nice try. She's really trying to help out this Woolly Bear. She ate the Wrath of my Empowered W. Auto attack W reset. Gore Drinker Q. Beautiful. I don't really know why Yas was over here. I killed his laner. He could just be mid right now. He's fishing for the kill. He actually gets it. It's a little surprising. Guess he's a little fed himself. Gore Drinker Q, fairly fluid animation. Can do them basically at the same time. And we're gonna stay on the split, try to grab a camp or two if we can. Yeah, it basically lets you cast Q during the Gore Drinker, which is nice. Get our Fury up to 50%, and then we should be able to kill the Slug. She's not gonna expect us to be here. She's likely just gonna walk into us. We'll hit her with a W. Auto attack W, Gore Drinker Q, E through, daughter. That's the burst, baby. She even burned her flash. As long as your first E nicks something, whether it's a enemy champion or enemy minion or a monster, you should be getting to use the second part of it. We're gonna stay on the split, look for some more things to eat without dying. All the enemies are missing, which is making me a little nervous, so we're gonna hold on to our E, and we have minions to dash through here to escape. We're leaving ourselves an escape route. In fact, I'm just gonna leave right now. I don't trust it. I don't see anyone on the map. And Vi is very, 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 very fed. She has more items than I do, and I'm giga fed. She has 156 CS. That's quite a bit for jungle. One reason I didn't auto attack W reset the Scuttle is because we want to take off its shield immediately. Our W will do that, so autoing it first wouldn't really benefit us. I'm not going to use my Q because I'm trying to keep my Fury up so I can use two empowerments and get to 100. Ooh, hey, Woolly Bear. Once you've been out of combat for 12 seconds, then your Fury starts to decay. Kind of sucks. Auto attack W reset. Gore Drinker Q, you back into him. Yeah, he's a goner. Black Cleaver would be very good against Volibear since he's stacking armor. I'm going the Death's Dance just to stay alive longer at a lower health threshold. That way we can kill stuff like the Vi. Until Volibear's double or triple armor item shouldn't be an issue. This game's spiraling out of control very quickly. It's very tempting to group, but it wouldn't work well. The Lux Q is AoE, her E is AoE. Ezreal's gonna be way too slippery for us to stay on top of consistently. And even if we do get on somebody, the Lux can just shield them. Now, our Empowered W does destroy shields, but still, If we don't have empowered W and they get luck shielded, it's going to be really hard to deal with. The whole team's dying. I need to pull back and grab some camps, or you can go over walls, mainly thin and small ones. But it can. Okay, we see Vi still up there. Come over here and grab this blue buff. Varus has enough range. My teammates should be able to survive underneath turrets if you just wave clears. Yasuo is going ham. And he gets it just barely. That's incredible because she even has Bork and plated. It's the power of one item Yasuo. Takes out a two item and a half Vi who's at a higher level. Amazing. Let's build up some fury. I think Lux is going to walk over here for blue buff. I have a huge hunch. She might eat it from that bush. Hopefully not, because it hurt you gives vision. Likely someone's going to come over here for the blue. I'm sitting on a lot of gold. I just can't be here when Vi shows up. They should come over here. I'm pretty certain of it. Very surprised she didn't come over here. Vi's been alive for a little bit, so she'd be right around here. I gotta reset. Death's Dance. We'll go straight into Sterix after that. Thresh is getting picked. We might have to give this dragon. Fighting at 4 versus 5 isn't a good idea. We can shove down mid lane, get full pressure. Even if they kill another teammate, they won't be able to do Baron off of it. Ooh. Whoa! I thought they were gonna go for dragon. They're just still pushing mid. A strange choice. Two item Ezreal, two item support. Varus just died, holy crap. We're just about to die. What is going on here? This is madness. Got big gore drinker underneath turret. Kind of wasted my W there, but we went in at the right time. Gave Yasuo space to do Yasuo things. They're violent for the dragon. It seems like neither team is very coordinated. My teammates are doing things without each other. Their team's doing things without each other. This is, yeah, I just can't get to her. Interesting solo queue. Vi's in the area. Probably shouldn't have played that in front of her. Now she's just gonna use her stupid sweeper and break that. And hold on to my E just in case Vi is here. I'll need the dash. She's triple item now, which is gross. Auto attack double reset and a Q. Holding on to Gore Drinker. I don't know where Vi is. Like to have that extra healing. And I'm gonna do my best to stay on this split push. Their next objective is Baron. They're definitely going to greed for Dragon Soul when that comes up. I think we could possibly end the game or at least get inhib if they go for Dragon Soul. And it is just a Cloud Drake Soul, which is one of the weaker souls. It's not quite as valuable as an Ocean or a Flame Soul. Gore Drinker Q. Hey, bud. Auto attack W reset and the E. Oh. That sucks. She's going to die, though, if she stays. She's so greedy. She needed to just leave. I could take like 8 turret shots and still have plenty of HP. I see most of her team's mid lane, so she has no pressure. If I didn't know where her teammates were, I wouldn't have done that. But since they showed on the map, it's a free freebie. They might end here, actually. My whole team just died. I definitely can't butt back and fight 3 of them. So I have to keep pushing and hope one of them backs. And they don't just go for the end, because I think they do have an end option here. I can ether these minions using them as an escape route. Yeah, Vi did exactly what I wanted her to do. I think they could have ended. Yasuo had 20 more seconds. This Thresh isn't very good, neither is the Varus or the Udyr. The Yasuo is definitely one of the stronger players on the team, just looking at least at CS wise. CS almost, oh my god. Right as I say that, CS almost always gives away the skills of the players. If you see someone is wildly under CS, I'd say 8 out of 10 times. It's like the only indicator you need to look at. Only exception is if the wave gets frozen on them and they're camped, which that can happen. Trying to decide what item to go here. I don't mind going Thornmail because the Vi self-healing, Volibear self-healing. Thornmail should be fine. Ezreal gets the pick on Varus. They can threaten Baron now. Vi's on the split. I don't think Vi can actually solo me at this point. Not on my R. Your Renekton R basically turns yourself into a Sunfire cape. And you get back a bunch of Fury very quickly. So most of your attacks become empowered. You basically do way more damage. Jeez, what is this? I think I actually have to reset. I don't have enough time to shove in this wave. This is so sloppy. I'm gonna buy an elixir. I think this is the last fight anyways. I had the flash. Volibear's on his support stuff there. I'm gonna hit this chick with my W. Q E wave. Holy crap, I'm gonna die. Something's burning me. Something's burning me real bad. Need the Yasuo windwall or something, bro. We're getting eaten alive over here. Where's the windwall? Got the Lux at least. I'm gonna die though. Vi is really fed and I can't get her off of me. This might have stalled the base, I'm hoping. Oh, not quite. Thresh can CC him. She's just so fed. Oh man. That's really interesting to watch. It is what it is though, guys, on Renekton. Even if you get really fed and you're carrying the game and taking up space, at the end of the day, if you're not allowed to split push and the enemy team has the better team fight comp, this is what it looks like. If you enjoyed this little Renekton top lane commentary guide, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. My name is Kingstix. Thank you for watching, and I'll catch you guys next time.